So when I began this process, I decided to start with the pants because they're the part that intimidated me the most. I know how to make normal pants, but because Sora's pants have a certain poofiness to them, I wasn't exactly sure where to begin. So I ended up buying a pattern on Etsy in order to assist me with the process, which is similar to how people use a recipe when they cook. And the pattern was only $7.50, so that was really nice. The large white paper is the pattern, and although it's hard then I cut that fabric out. The third one is just like a large pouch, and the fourth pocket, which is the one on the back, is similar to like the back pants pocket on jeans. All the pockets are larger than average in order to create that kind of cartoony look. In addition, all of his pockets are outlined with something called bias tape. And once all eight of those were done, I sewed the back leg piece to the front leg piece. When I did this, I sewed it inside out so that the raw fabric would be on the inside and would look nice and neat on the outside where people would actually see it. So that basically finished the major part of the pants. After that, I had to connect the two leg pieces through the crotch area and the waistband. I put a zipper in just like normal jeans do, so that they are just like a normal pair of pants.
After that, I added elastic band at the end so that they would scrunch up towards my legs.
The next big part of Sora's outfit is his jacket. I started out by using a plain black hoodie that I bought off of Amazon for $11. My plan was to alter the hoodie instead of making a new one completely from scratch. I decided to do this because 1, it's a lot easier to do, and 2, it saves me a lot of money from having to buy extra fabric. I started off by trimming the long sleeves on the hoodie to short sleeves that rest a little bit above my elbows, which was about 13 inches long from my neck. After those small steps, I decided to begin with his hoodie pockets because I thought they were the biggest part of the hoodie. The pockets were already made, so all I had to do was place my gray fabric over top of the pockets. I didn't have to worry about hemming this fabric because, similar to the pockets on the pants, the hoodie pockets are outlined with bias tape, so that would cover up any of the raw fabric. I couldn't sew the gray fabric down at the edge of the pocket where it opens up because it would sew the pocket shut, so I had to hand sew it, which is much more time consuming than using a machine, but it's not that difficult. Then I repeated this process with the other pocket. After both pockets were completed, I added the line of fabric that lines the bottom of Sora's hoodie. There's a thick line of white, and underneath that there's a thinner line of red fabric. I was able to sew them on with the machine fairly easily. After that, I added the 2 red stripes that travel up along with the zipper. This part was a tad more complicated than the previous steps. Because it was next to the zipper, I couldn't put it through the machine because it was too thick. So I machine sewed the fabric on one side, but then I had to hand sew it on the other side that was close to the zipper. After that, I had to add red fabric over top of the hoodie. Because the hoodie is curved, I had to do it in 2 sections instead of 1, with a seam running down the middle at the very top of my head. After that step, I was mostly done with his jacket. I just had to add the plaid flaps that he has that lay across his zipper. What I had to do for this was outline the plaid triangles with the same gray bias tape I used for the pants pockets. Then I hand sewed the flaps across the zipper. This replicates the look that Sora has, but it's kind of funny because this prevents the zipper from being usable. Anyways, the last thing I had to do was sew the 6 buttons onto the hoodie for his decoration.
Styling a wig to be like Sora's hair is extremely time consuming. His spiky hair defies gravity and doesn't act like normal hair in the slightest. There are a few materials needed in order to style a wig like this. First is obviously scissors to cut the hair. Next is super strong hairspray and hair gel. The brand that most cosplayers use is called Got to Be Glued. The last 2 necessities are a hair dryer, which dries the hairspray in place, and a lot of hair bands. The first step I took was sectioning off parts of his hair into the different spikes that he has, using the small hair band. I began with the short hair spikes that are closest to the top of his head, where everything kind of parts. I don't think it matters where a person begins, but for me, this was just easier to visualize. Then I worked my way down to his bangs in the front. I sectioned off a few things closer to the back of his head, but for the most part, I focused on only sectioning off the front and his sides. After that, I began the actual styling. I grabbed a spike and then cut it down to the length I wanted. After that, I teased the spike a little in order to have density and for it to be able to almost stand up on its own. After that, it was time to hairspray it. Once I sprayed the spike with hairspray, I used the hairdryer on low heat in order to dry the hairspray. This saves me the time of having to hold it in place with my fingers for a super long time while I'm waiting for the hairspray to dry. Once that was complete, I used hair gel and put it onto the very tip of the spike in order to prevent the hairs from splitting apart. A little hair gel goes a long way, so not too much had to be used. In fact, using too much gel will cause the synthetic fibers of the wig to all clump together and will make the wig look really bad.